Market father is on his way to Poland tonight, hoping the trip will end a 2.5-year legal battle to bring his sons home. Stephen Watkins spoke to CBC News as he boarded a flight to Warsaw tonight. Matt Llewellyn has the story.
What are you doing?
Playing my game.
Yeah.
Me too.
This is the last video that Stephen Watkins took of his two sons before they were taken by their mother. In 2009, the boys didn't show up to school. Police say their mother drove them to the U.S., where they then boarded a plane to Germany. An arrest warrant came too late.
There's all these children being abducted to this country, and something seems to be going wrong with the Polish court system.
Watkins is relying on the Hague Convention, an international piece of law set up to prevent situations like this. But the problem, Watkins says, the Polish courts don't see this as an international matter.
We're dealing with international law, and this is not a custody matter.
He does, however, have legal custody of his sons here in Canada, claims backed up in letters from the Department of Foreign Affairs.
The only one step I did not take is I did not refuse my sons to see their mom.
But custody conflicts like this one could be more than just a difference in Poland's court system. This Mississauga father shares an eerily similar story to Watkins and says these type of abductions are a cultural problem.
When the child is abducted to Poland, basically like the child's coming home. That's how the society looked at that abduction.
Neil, as you can imagine, this is taking quite the toll on Stephen Watkins financially as well as emotionally. Financially, he hasn't worked since the boys went missing, and it's cost him around $250,000, about $250,000. Now, he'll be back in Warsaw on Wednesday, where he'll be appealing to the Polish courts to let his sons finally come home to Canada with him. Reporting live from the newsroom, I'm Matt Llewellyn.
Thanks so much for this, Matt.